All right, everyone, let's give it up for Shalini Pandey. So, Shalini, you're the new heartthrob of the Telugu audience. How does it feel?
It feels, I don't know, I don't feel anything because I don't have that circuit of having that feeling that I'm an actress now.
Okay.
Or anything has changed. Only change I feel is when I go out,
okay,
when people come with for selfies. And I feel why. My first reaction for that is that why do they want selfie with me? What have I done?
Really?
Yeah, because my first thing is I treat acting as something else. Okay, my favorite actor. Maybe I look up to some good, great films. Like my favorite film is Clockwork Orange. So in that, actors, like if they have done great work like that, then you go for a selfie, you know.
Right.
I feel, what have I done? Why they are asking for a selfie? But it feels very good because they come with genuine feelings, genuine love. They'll not bug you. So I like that. That has changed. But then I don't feel anything.
So you have your regular sleep cycles? Like people come and ask you autograph and take selfies and all. Mm. Do you go back home with... you know, that nice, that elated feeling, and you don't sleep in the night? Because I don't sleep in the night if someone says a nice shirt or...
No, I am very self-obsessed that way.
Okay.
So I have treated myself like that only since childhood, no?
Okay.
So I don't feel anything different in that. I don't go, oh, wow, wow, yes. But then I feel nice. It
okay.
feels inner way, it feels very nice that, okay, they genuinely love you. Because I feel that they unconditionally love you, because they don't expect, no, to,
okay,
they don't know if I love them back or no. Everybody, I might even not remember their name or their faces, still they'll come and talk to me.
Okay.
So that feeling is so good that they really accepted you, not even being from here, they accepted you in a very nice way. So that actually fills me up.
Telugu or we are all like that, trust me. It's like one hit and then we all love you.
One hit.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
So now tell me, okay, so let's not talk about pre-Arjun Reddy and post-Arjun Reddy. Let's talk about your, you know, the number of followers you have on Facebook and Instagram pre-Arjun Reddy and post-Arjun Reddy.
I don't even remember that. Now, you know what? Somebody has actually sent me a screenshot before Arjun Reddy, after Arjun Reddy, followers, now and then.
Okay.
So then I realized, oh my God, my followers have increased. I don't go to social, I don't like social websites. Like, I will not, yeah.
Seriously?
I don't like Facebook. I used to enjoy Facebook during my college time.
Okay.
But then I don't now. I've got bored with that. I got bored with Insta. What will you do? Just post your pictures and read the comments. I don't like that.
Do people send you flowery messages over Instagram?
Sugary messages.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Can you share one of them with us? A couple of them with us?
Like now, though.
Did people tattoo your name on their hands and neck?
You've seen that video.
No,
yes.
What? It really happened?
Yes,
it's just a guess.
You've seen
me.
That video.
No, I haven't.
It has actually happened. One guy from Bangalore, he tattooed my whole picture on his back.
Okay.
And...
So the country hasn't changed much.
And then I thought, oh my God, wasting your body ink, getting a body ink. Why? I mean, if I was like... some heartthrob like Madhuri Dixit and all that level, then you can get.
Okay.
But then I thought that's very sweet. Then I called that guy. I actually spoke to that guy.
You did that?
Yeah, because somebody's getting a tattoo.
Wow.
Of you.
So guys, if you want Shalini Pandey to call you up,
wow,
you know what to do. Okay. Yeah.
Okay. Wow.
Right. So he did that.
Yeah.
Your entire picture.
Yeah, my entire picture.
It's scary also.
It's very scary. It's permanent.
Okay. So is that the only weird thing, or did something else also happen? Like, did people donate blood on your name, or?
That's too much. Nobody donated blood on.
Someone's injured himself. That's not too much, but donating blood is too much.
But why will somebody donate blood on my name?
They do that. Are you kidding me? You have like Chiranjeevi blood bank and Pawan Kalyan fans donating blood.
That's Chiranjeevi. That's Pawan Kalyan.
Give two more hits and trust me, even you'll have that here.
Okay. Anyways, but nobody did that. But then people, I think, like now. People feel that I'm Preeti.
Okay.
How was Preeti? She was very simple, homely girl. But I'm not exactly how Preeti dresses. I'm like that.
Okay.
I'm how I am. So now they'll text me that, madam, don't dress Western clothes, ma'am. No, madam, you should not wear clothes like that.
Okay.
You should not reveal yourself. But that's not revealing. That's how I am. I'll wear shorts and I'll sit very comfortably because I was a sporty kid back then.
Okay.
And I am not, as in, I am Preeti inner ways, mein, but I'm not Preeti how Preeti reacts.
Okay.
So I'm very talkative. I'll talk, I'll give expressions, but they feel that I'm, that is not me. So they're like, be Preeti, madam, we like you not talking.
Wow.
But I can't do that.
She is talkative, I mean, in the sense, and don't get me wrong, perhaps you're the only star. I mean, I've called you up on the phone and you spoke to me, what, like for 5 or 10 minutes?
Hey, don't. People will feel I'm a chatterbox. It's not like you also spoke.
Yeah, but because you
and
spoke.
We spoke about work.
Yeah.
We spoke about work.
Yeah, books and work. Books. It doesn't generally happen.
Yeah, actually, if the topic to me interests, like if it's book, and if I feel the person who's talking to me is making sense, I will speak. Otherwise, I go blank.
Okay.
That's a different side also. I will not talk, utter a word also.
Okay.
So I'm like that also in ways.
So I made a lot of sense. Okay, let's skip that. It's not about me.
It was not that.
Yeah. Now, so tell us something about, you're from Jabalpur.
Yeah.
I've been to Jabalpur once.
Yeah.
Yeah, I have a friend from Jabalpur here. Nandita.
Hey, wow, you're from Jabalpur?
Yeah.
Wow. So, which area?
Madatal.
Yeah. Okay. I'm from Vijayanagar.
Oh.
Okay.
I'm from Vijayanagar too, but in Hyderabad. Vijayanagar Colony. Yeah.
Okay. That is huge. Huh? Yeah. Very different.
Huh? So, when I had been to Jabalpur and I asked Nandita, is there some place we can hang out in the night? And she said, Tendi. I said, wow, Tendi is there in Jabalpur.
Tendi opens till 12? I didn't know that.
I went to Tendi and I was the only one in Tendi.
That is actually, that's the only cool place. You can actually hang around, you can feel you are a youth.
Okay.
You belong to the youth. Otherwise, I love Jabalpur. Why? Because that is the place where I started doing theatres.
Okay.
And it's very culturally rich and I've never seen, because I'm from theatres, I've travelled a lot of places, no?
Okay.
So I've seen different variety of plays and culture. But I've never seen how it is in Jabalpur. So that is why I love that place. And also, because I'm born and brought up there, obviously a sensitive thing. But then, it's not, I've not been out. After 10, I don't think so I've been out. Because my dad was strict. So he didn't allow me, other than being in theatres, he didn't allow me. So I didn't go to Tendi also on 10. I don't even remember. Tendi.
Okay. Okay. This is Eat Street. This is very famous street where you have a lot of street
Chow Party.
Chow Party.
But that's there in every North Indian place. Yeah.
So, okay. So, I've been to Bedeghat.
Bedeghat.
Yeah, it's really nice. I've seen that waterfall in the movie Ashoka.
It's very pretty, no?
Yeah. I mean, it was prettier with Kareena Kapoor, but even without that.
I am so proud of Please Jabalpur. They're very pretty places.
So am I, yeah.
Why are you proud?
Because Jabalpur treated me well, it hosted me well.
Yeah, very, very homely people.
Yeah, I know. I also slept in the railway station once.
And then also you'll not feel you're alone.
Yeah. Are you kidding me? You will never feel alone in any train headed to Jabalpur. Have you taken a train from Jabalpur to anywhere?
Yes. I have taken a train. I used to travel in trains only because, you know, my father used to tell me travel in flights because safety. He was a very possessive father.
Yeah, yeah.
So he'll not let, if I'm traveling alone, he'll not let me travel in any other medium. But I got bored in flights. I'm like, what will I do? Nobody talks.
Okay.
And also, if you have urgency, then though I didn't have any urgency. Now I can just be on my own free. Now I have urgency. I have to take just 2 hours to fly and all. But then a lot of my, I used to travel very frequently to Bombay. I love that city.
Okay.
I love that city. So, that is the only city where I want to live.
Right.
So I used to go there by train a lot of times.
Okay. So you know, when you go to Jabalpur or when you travel from Jabalpur to somewhere else in a train, so people do talk, there are a lot of people. In fact, there's so many people that you go to your berth and you don't find any place to sit.
Yeah.
And then there are people on your berth and say, theek hai, koi problem nahi hai, aake adjust kar lo. Like, it's my berth.
They'll do that. They'll very nice. They'll offer you food. They'll make you, your family, they'll start talking. They'll bug you. They'll not sleep, let you sleep at night. You feel like you're traveling with a family. But that's good only, you know. You will not get bored.
That's how you felt?
You didn't feel like, hey, South Indians are a little reserved.
Yeah, we are reserved. I told them, look, I'll complain it to the TC. He said, my TC himself told me to sit. But yeah, I like Jabalpur. Okay, now tell me about this university top ranker thing.
First of all, I never said I topped. I said I was a rank holder because my father never wanted me to be in acting.
Okay.
So the only reason he was like, okay, do theatres was if you rank good.
Okay.
But then for me, I cannot come for, I have to study a lot. Engineering is not just a just one, it's like that I used to study in one night and get good marks, but that is because
we call that one day batting here. Like just before exams we sit and we
so I used to get third or fourth or maybe fifth, but not first and second. People are writing that she topped the college. No, my friends are calling me, Achcha. You're telling people you topped the college. Such a lie. But I said, I never said I topped the college. I was like, I got third rank, fourth rank, fifth also.
Okay.
But and I was a very, I held a very nice position in the college when it's not even in the terms of rank. You know, people, my teachers look up to me in that sense because I was a very active kid. And a quite rebellious kid also.
Oh. Yeah. In South here, we are obsessed about engineering.
Like,
like even before a kid is born, we decide which college.
So that is that was decided
CBIT
for me also.
CBIT and MGIT and stuff.
Yeah.
So you would, amongst the family audience and elders too, from now onwards, you should say that, you know, I'm an engineer turned actress. And then trust me, even the family audience would most probably tattoo your name. Like you would be a role model for them and say, and they might just go to their kids and say, hey, listen.
She turned into an actress.
Finish off your engineering.
And see.
Rank it well and then.
Yeah, and you know, I think everybody has a perception that if you don't do anything, you can become an actor.
Yeah.
Don't do anything, you don't have to study, it's not like that.
Okay.
I feel every actor who's a great actor, anybody who's a great actor who acts good, anybody, be it anybody, he or she is very intelligent. Anybody, I'm not commenting on anybody particular, but anybody who I felt is a great actor, and if I study about them here, it's not about studying how much.
Okay.
It's not about if you do M.Tech or B.Tech, then you're very intelligent. It's not, intelligence cannot be measured by that.
Yeah.
But you have to be very sensible in what you know, you have to be well read.
Right.
Like, I really respect.
So who amongst the actors, since you seem to be looking up to great actors, whom would you rate great actors? Let's not rate them on a number one, number two, number three basis.
Mm.
But give me three of your favorite actors.
Three of my favorite, anybody, yeah, male,
across,
female.
Across male, female, across the language, no barrier.
There are too many. I love Kamal Hassan, sir. I love him. Okay.
Are you calling him Kamal Hassan, sir, now? Or would you?
No. You know what? There was a time because I am a big fan of Madhuri Dixit.
Okay.
So, you know, from my mouth, it didn't come out ever Madhuri Dixit. It came out always Madhuri Dixit ji, Madhuri Dixit ma'am. So my friends used to tease me, why are you saying Madhuri Dixit ji? It sounds very awkward. But it comes automatically.
Seriously?
Yeah.
Guys, did you ever try to, when speaking about her, did you ever say Shalini Pandey ji?
It look very odd now if you say Shalini Pandey ji. It make me look old.
Okay.
But no, it comes out like that. So Kamal Hassan sir, I like. I look to him. I love Guru Dutt.
Okay.
As an actor, director, as a person, as I don't know. There are certain people who I really love.
Okay.
But I can feel that there is a part of me, if they were alive, I can really connect to them. So there's some connection which I feel. So it's not if in terms of actor, then I really like Kamal Hassan sir, I like Amitabh Bachchan sir, I like Ranbir Kapoor.
Sir?
Ranbir Kapoor is.
What?
He's younger only, you know.
Okay.
Kamal Hassan sir comes like that.
Okay.
And I like Deepak Dobrial.
You know who's Deepak
Dobrial? I'm nodding my head, so go with the flow. Don't
you know now who's Deepak?
It's like you're one of those annoying relatives, you know, who my mom.
I am annoying.
No, they come and they say, do you remember me? I say.
Deepak Dobrial is the one who acted in Tanu Veds Manu.
Okay.
You don't even know what Tanu Veds Manu is.
I've seen Tanu Veds Manu too.
I like Manoj Vajpayee then.
Yeah.
And I like, there are a lot of character artists which I love. Rather than just being a hero or heroine, I love Madhuri Dixit. I love her. And I love Sridevi.
Okay.
There are still many which I can't remember now which I love. But there are people who I really love. And it's not that, oh, they are famous. Oh, they are actors. Oh, they are stars. It's not that. It's pure love.
Okay. Personality based. Mm-hmm. Right. So now I managed to nail you on your favorite actors. Now, what is this with books? Your Facebook talks about books and I mean,
Facebook.
We've not been stalking you, but we.
You are stalking.
No, I didn't. Varshini did this, all that for me. Like,
okay.
So what's it with books? Like, is it through theater or were you genuinely interested in books from a very
young age? no, no, very young age, though, no. Mm-hmm. Very young age, I used to read added written books. Okay, but then I was not a nerd reader.
Okay.
I was never interested into studies.
Okay.
When I was a kid, I always wanted. I was a very moody kid. So if you see my report cards, no, you'll feel in one, like in half yearly, I'll do very well. Okay. Then in some unit tests, I'll fail.
All right.
Because I was a moody kid. If I don't feel like studying, I'll not study. And if my father used to bash me, now you have to get good marks, I'll not get you this, then I'll study. So,
oh, used to work opposite with us. It's like whenever our folks tell us to do something, it's like they build a resistance against it. But yeah.
No, but because I was very scared of my father from, because he didn't let me do my things. But I love my father and very much. And so I was that, so I was never interested in reading. But then when I got to theatres, though,
right.
I had to read a lot of scripts.
Okay.
We had to do plays, no?
Right.
So I read Rakesh Mohan's plays. I read this Amrita Pritham's plays, which you don't know, by the way, who they, am I talking about? They're very, very, very established people in terms of writing, in terms of their work.
Wow.
So I remember that I read one play, which I was, first day of the theatre, I read one play, which was just a 15 minutes play. And this is 8 pages, Amrita Pritham. By the way, who Amrita Pritham is the writer of Pinjar movie.
Okay.
Okay. I am not even kidding. I got goosebumps because the way she, nobody touches subject like what she's done. And back then,
right.
As in, it's not now. It's not, not a play. It's not a play that's written now, no? It's a play that's written quite long back.
Right.
So I read that and I was like, oh my God, I should start reading. What am I doing in life? Because reading influences you, reading helps you, especially if you somebody wants to be an actor or any artist,
right.
You need to read.
Okay.
You need to figure out different, because I'm an actor, I can't experience everything. You know, in my small age, I can't experience everything.
Okay.
How can I experience is just watching films, or maybe I feel more than watching films, reading helps you a lot because then you imagine your own world.
Right.
Watching though, you will get a set of whole set of play happening in front of you. There's no imagination happening. Reading, you can imagine characters,
yes.
You can imagine the whole scenario, everything is on you. You are the director, you are the actor, everything is you. So I felt that's the best part. And then I started reading.
Okay, and this is around what age and what?
Around my second year of college.
Wow, so you started pretty late.
Yeah, pretty late.
Okay.
But then
you're there, yeah, okay.
No. Today also, it's not that I've read a lot of books.
Okay.
But what I read, I go totally into it. And no, see, I'm not somebody who will, brag about that. I've read this much books. I've read 5 books, 7 books. But what I read, I've read, I know exactly.
Okay.
I can talk about that word to word, page to page. It's like that. It's in me.
Okay.
So I believe in whatever you do. Do it nicely. Otherwise, don't do it. It does not matter how much number of times you've done that or how much number of books you've read. Does not matter. If you read something, it's for me, it's not for bragging. And also I don't recommend people books. If I don't like if I like somebody, if I really like you, then I'll be referring you book.
Okay.
I'll not refer you book. I'll judge people and I'll feel okay, he's in the radar of that, okay, then I'll refer books, otherwise I'll not refer.
So you belong to one of those. Yeah, see I've seen people who from theater or who read a lot of books, they have a lot of intellectual vanity, like
you don't consider me one of those. I'm not.
No, I'm saying, yeah.
No, but I'm not. See, that's what I'm saying. It's not I'll always talk about these things.
Okay.
But you know what? If I've read something like Fountainhead, okay?
Fountainhead. How many of you have read Fountainhead here? Wow. Okay, a lot of people can
relate. It's an amazing book, right?
Yeah.
I read the book.
Okay.
And you know, earlier, I never used to read books with this much of pages and stuff. So I used to be like, who will read, who will take so much time and all. But when I read Fountain, which was referred to me by a friend, and that was my stage where I was struggling with my parents to join films, and my engineering was getting complete. It was not getting completed, but it was in second year of college.
Right.
And I didn't want it to do engineering.
Okay.
Every day I was wasting.
Okay.
So that time I read Fountainhead.
Okay.
I love what she wrote. I love every sentence makes a sense. It's
okay.
So deep. That's what I love. I love people like.
Okay.
All right. So,
hey, my God, people will feel I'm such an intellectual. I'm getting that image.
Go ahead. I think that's good.
Yeah. My father will love this. He'll finally feel.
Fantasy.
it finally feel my engineering is turning out to be something nice.
Wow. Yeah. Okay. So let's see. Now let's see if your engineering has really turned out that great, or you know, how much have you derived from books? We have a small game here.
Okay. I'm not deprived much. Yeah. But then,
so since you read a lot, okay, let's see how good is your. Let's start off with an easy word.
Okay.
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 Here you go.
Hey, nincom poop is an idiot.
See?
Everybody knows that.
Is it? How many of you know what is an income poop?
I used to.
See?
Ah. Okay. Oh, only we both know?
Yeah.
You didn't know what was nincom poop?
Okay, a lot of people. All right. Let's go. So you'll have to spell or you'll have to pronounce the word. You'll have to guess the word.
Okay.
And let's see how well you score.
Maverick.
Yeah.
I think I know that word.
A maverick?
I think somebody... I think somebody who's a, who's a well-known, well-read person or somebody who's close to genius.
Yeah, okay. So, okay, let's not drag this further. So, a maverick is someone who's a genius.
Who's a genius.
Yeah, who's good at
I
his
knew
work.
That, okay.
Yeah. Generally, Ram Gopal Varma is referred as a maverick. Back in those days.
Hey, back in those
days. Yeah. Now,
I am not commenting.
Hopefully, he gets back his swing.
Lollygag. Lollygag.
So, the word is lollygag. Yeah. For the camera.
Somebody who forgets.
Lollygag is someone who forgets.
Forgets being something or something like that. Or somebody who who's a waste.
Yeah,
like
it's correct.
Like that, no?
Yeah, yeah.
Lollygag.
It's not.
Hey, no, like I'm not. I'm seriously guessing.
Yeah, someone who wastes a lot of time.
Exactly.
Correct.
Hey, mine right. Was right. No.
So you're doing okay.
Quite well, no?
Yeah, quite well.
Collywobbles. I know somebody who's afraid of losing, afraid of remembering words.
Yeah, I'm just checking. No!
No! No! Collywobbles.
Collywobbles. Do you have collywobbles? It sounds like an expletive, but I'm not cursing you. Does anyone have collywobbles? No?
Wait, you don't say. I'll guess, okay?
Yeah, sure.
Stomachache?
Yes.
Yay!
A strange feeling in your stomach is called as
butterflies
collywobbles.
Butterflies also?
It could be anything.
Mm.
Yeah. Butterflies, see, rats, wobbles. Okay. Last few. Let's see. She's doing good so far.
Abibliophobia. That is missing out of words.
Phobia,
na?
Yeah.
Phobia means some fear.
Yeah, phobia means fear.
Fear.
Okay. Do you know who's a bibliophile?
Yeah, who reads a lot of books.
Yeah, so abibliophobia.
Who misses out being reading a lot.
Yeah, someone who's afraid that he might run out of books.
Yeah.
To read. Can you imagine that? People are like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, people are like that. I know one of my friends is like that.
Like, she gets all stressed out.
Yeah, she's
no
like,
books.
I didn't read. Okay. I have to read. Even if she's not reading, she'll carry a book. And you know, I was also developing this.
Okay.
Yeah, so I used to carry books. Even if I'm not reading, I used to just touch it.
That's called as OCD.
Fine. Fine. I still don't have, but.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I used to do that in engineering too. I mean, I used to hold a book.
Engineering
I used to
books?
Sleep with it. Yeah, I
so
mean,
that's worse.
Hopefully, I thought I can imbibe some of it, but.
Yeah, I didn't have with that intellectual books. I have with nice books.
I'm
okay?
Talking about subject. Like,
that's what I'm saying. I don't have with that.
I flunked
very
in all these subjects. My
guys
first
usually flunk, man.
Barring English, I flunked in all subjects.
But guys usually do.
Yeah. Okay. See? Yeah, okay. We have a feminist here.
Yeah. Hey, so I am a feminist. It's not
right.
A bad thing.
So we have a couple of more. Oh, okay, this is interesting.
Asshole.
Yeah. Can you again pronounce it? Can you be loud?
Asshole.
Okay, once more. Loud.
Asshole.
Okay.
Okay, you want people now to curse me?
No, yeah. So what's. Can you guess the meaning of asshole?
Yeah, I'll kill you. You know. somebody.
You there, just guess. Make a weird guess.
Somebody who fear of asking out or somebody who asks a lot.
Just because the word ask is there, you're drilling it so much. Okay. So asshole means someone who asks for advice, listens to advice, but
and
never
then,
follows it.
who asks also, listens also, but never follows it.
Never follows it.
Okay.
So that's an ask hole.
Okay.
Would you be knowing? Be. Would you be knowing any ask hole?
Yeah, I think you are. One. Hey, what is this word? I got two words. TOing.
Yeah.
Hey, what is this weird word, Rhea?
Okay. TOing is a really weird word. Like, it's. I was surprised that something like that exists.
You also didn't know what was this.
Until recently, I didn't.
TOing. Can you frame a sentence so that I'll guess?
Okay.
It's so a bad word? Okay, fine. Frame a sentence. Frame a sentence, okay.
A lot of guys and girls, if they're single for a very long time, they end up TOing.
They end up TOing.
Yeah. Why? It's not. It happens, apparently.
Yeah, I can't use that word. I'm Preeti, man.
Okay, TOing is imagining a fictitious or an imaginary girlfriend or boyfriend.
But you can't use that word, no? What is the word for that?
Yeah, it is. The word is this. So, in case you miss someone or you don't have someone in your life.
Achha, I didn't use that word. Okay, frame it in a very nice way. Huh?
Yeah, so you consider a statue or a pillow as your romantic accomplice and...
You get erotic.
Yeah, okay. Okay, last and final word. Let's see.
Bumfuzzle is confused.
Okay, she's done well. I think it's just two words that she hasn't got. Two or three words.
Two.
Remaining, I helped.
Achcha? I nailed it.
Okay. So, now this is a question out of my,
curiosity.
Not just out of curiosity, but the fact that, after Arjun Reddy, okay, a lot of people are, the movie all happens to be about
a guy
and his breakup. Or his post, what can I say?
Was post it breakup? It was breakup.
Can you label it as a breakup?
What happened in Arjun Reddy?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was basically not a breakup. They didn't speak about it. Yeah. It was just a confusion, miscommunication happened.
Miscommunication. Mm. So, okay. So someone, a heartbroken guy. So everyone... empathizes, I wouldn't say empathizes, but connects with the heartbroken guy. I mean, a lot of people, it's very stereotype, guys are going through pain, they grow.
Yeah, they are doing drugs.
Yeah, they're doing
drugs, but it's not
they
like
grow
that.
Beer and stuff and all.
Daru and all they do.
So how is it for a girl, post-breakup or post-heartbreak?
Everybody goes through heartbreak.
Do they do the same? Do they grow beards and drink a lot? I mean, do they...
How can we go
beer? Do they drink a lot?
Drink. Generally, I am kind of a person who moves on very fast. So, but then I also had one...
Generally, it's like that with girls. Trust me, they move on.
Are you mad? It's not like that, okay? It is not like that. I've had a friend who went crazy.
Guy, no? I know.
Girlfriend. Who went crazy after breakup. 1 year, she couldn't recover.
Oh, 1 year? Like, that's the upper limit.
Yeah, I don't think so. It's just, I think it's just, it's being...
couple of months to 1 year is the period.
Worse?
Yeah.
How much time did you take?
Tell
me.
Okay.
Everybody is like that. It's just humans. They will feel bad. And I did go through a breakup during the college. Oh my God, my father is going to see this. And that was a time where I was struggling with my parents also, going through this breakup also. So,
is that guy alive? Did he jump off a building or is he safe? I hope he is.
He is one of my best friends though.
Okay. And I think it calls for an awe moment.
But then we are still friends and we have off and on moments. I've moved on.
Okay.
Because obviously, different professions we couldn't have matched. And then recently I had a breakup.
Okay.
This is really terribly bad. Matlab, it.
No, I'm.
Hey, don't
that's
do
how,
that.
That's how, yeah, okay.
But it is really bad. As in, you see, for an actor, it's more difficult because you have to go and be happy in front of the world. You can't just show your dull face in front of the world. You have to be looking good. You have to look good, even if you've cried the whole night.
Yeah.
You have to look good.
Yeah.
So all those things happen, but I think it happens with everybody. Everybody overthinks. during this time, because they'll think what, why this. Every sensitive person, I am a sensitive person, so I went through a breakup, but I didn't do all this. I started drinking. I will not do all this shit. It's just, I think that's just a fashion now, which is just shown in the films. I don't think so. Generally, it might have happened with everybody. It happens with.
It's been happening what, since ages, since times immemorial. We get bloody drunk and we die. You guys go what, do retail therapy, go shopping.
But I think you follow the film only and do that. I don't think so.
How did you cope with the breakup? You went shopping, right? It eased your pain.
I hate shopping. Okay, I hate shopping. I'm very lousy at shopping. Ask my stylist. She cannot take me to shopping because she's like, you don't know what to pick. You don't have any girly side. I'll pick from men's section. Okay. That is what I am. So forget shopping. But how I recovered, I am somebody who's sensitive, no? So I relate to everything. Even if some song, it sounds very familiar, but that happens. If some song you've heard together, you will relate to that song. You will not want that song to play.
Wow. So you've been listening to that breakup song from Arjun Reddy?
I don't. Okay. No, that's different. I'm little sensitive to that film because it's Preeti. But then breakups are difficult for everybody. And people think it's the, because my friend, I have dealt with a very bad breakup for a friend. Okay. And she wanted to commit suicide. It was so bad. She tried a lot of things. But then it feels it's the end of the world, because generally, if I am nobody to give advice, because to me also it felt, oh shit, you showed so dependent on each other for emotionally, you know. Yeah. So you feel that it's end of the world. Right. But then it's not end of the world. You will,
you move on. Else.
You have.
And you emotionally latch on to the next.
You do that?
No, I'm saying in general, people.
So in general, everybody does that. Yeah. So breakups are a part of life, and I take it as a positive thing. Why? Because I'm an actor. Okay. I feel it will teach me only. Okay. As in, it will let my emotions come out. I'm not a very expressive girl, to be very frank. Okay. Real life, I will not express. You will not even know about me. See, you don't know what Shalini is. Even if I talk to you, if I tell you what my favorite book is, you'll not know how I am. I'm very extremely weird to live with.
Wow.
Extremely difficult person to live with.
Okay.
So I'm not expressive. So breakups or any emotional things brings the emotional side out of me.
Wow.
And that is how you can portray
what,
the
you're like Adele or something of that sort? She has a breakup and then she goes on to deliver a hit. So, like, she
sings. See, that is how every art, you know what? I read a quote which said that heartbreaks are good for heartbreak is good for good art, something like that.
Okay.
A good artist, somebody who's a good artist is broken somewhere or the other, is dealing with some pain. Forget it's a pain from a boy.
Right.
It might be for me, it might be my family issues or something like back then.
Right.
It might be that. So everybody, it's a good breakup or being sad is important also to bring your sadness out. But you should not take it in a way that you should end your life or should take it in a bag. And I don't think you should go on daru and stuff.
No, but you still didn't answer my question. What do girls do?
What do girls do? See, I don't know what other girls do. What I did is,
okay.
I know.
What did you do?
I did nothing. You can't do anything. To be very frank, I can't advise. Because, you know what? If somebody will tell you, go to the pubs, get good music, it does not help.
Right.
First of all, loud music does not help. Being happy does not help. Cry. I feel cry it out, take it all out. Because if you get that in,
you know, I'm just saying, wow, there's a way out for girls. They can cry.
What a sexist you are, man.
No, what?
Gee.
You, it's easy. What, guys, would you come and hug me if I cry? No, what?
Exactly. Who asked you not to? And who said guys don't cry?
Prasad, he's crying already.
You know what? No, truly, I would fall for a guy who would show me the sensitive side, who would cry and come in front of me, cry and say, I really love you and all. I might fall. I not feel that guy is weak. You know, I would feel that he's very strong to put that emotions out in front of me. I feel that.
Okay.
So I feel that you should be that strong that you can put the emotions. Crying is not a weakness. I feel crying is a very strong thing. You should not cry for attention, obviously.
Right.
That's a different thing.
Okay.
Okay. And now you feel, now you'll tell me that girls do that, no?
No.
No, but that's,
I respect all human beings.
Okay.
I don't know. I mean, right, fine. Not all of them, but.
So I did nothing. I did not do any drinking stuff or smoking or getting into drugs. Obviously not.
Okay.
And I couldn't concentrate, to be very honest. You cannot concentrate, and at that point of time I had to go to the sets.
Okay.
And act also.
Oh, this was like, yeah. Oh wow.
So, and the film ended, so everything ended. Okay. But back then it was very difficult, and I couldn't do anything. It's just very easy to, you know, get people advice that, you know, you'll get somebody, get involved with some other guy. Don't do that. It does not work. First of all, it really does not work. Getting involved with some other person, it does not help. It will make you more vulnerable, I feel.
Okay.
So, I think you should give yourself some time.
Okay.
Cry it out. There'll be days you'll be crying. There'll be nights you'll be crying. Eat.
Okay.
I ate.
That's called as emotional eating. Yeah. Right.
Yeah, I ate. Wow. Work out, look good. Because if you start looking bad after all the crying, and then you'll go in much more depression. Oh, should I look bad also? My hair is not good. Because you're crying. You're destroying your body.
Yeah.
So exercise, look good. I feel that's the only thing.
So Shalini Pandey is single right now. Wow.
Yes, I'm single.
Great. So, so I mean, are you? I mean, I'm not saying that.
Are you ready to mingle?
Could be, yeah.
No,
not yet.
I don't know. You can't decide these things, no?
Yeah,
you, can
you
just,
cannot.
If you can just like somebody, you can just like somebody. Right. No matter when, where. I can't say I'm very busy for love.
Right.
I can't make statements like
that. So, guys, in the back of their mind, so it's at least we can hit on Shalini Pandey.
But it's very extremely difficult to live with me. My father told me once that my father said, I swear, my father told me that I feel very bad, extremely bad for the guy who will end up with you.
Two of them are already, I don't know where they are, but.
Okay. But I'm a very good girl, please. Yeah.
Cool. Okay, so considering that you're single, okay. And there are a couple of people who would want to, you know, hit on you, impress you, flirt with you.
Yeah.
I have a couple of pickup lines.
Okay.
Let's see how does it work in general with girls or with
okay,
you.
Okay, fine.
Okay, so you'll have to rate me on a scale of the lines, not me.
Okay. I know.
Yeah, so I know my rating.
Okay.
Okay, so you'll have to rate these lines. Okay, so for every attempt, say on a scale of 0 to 5, how is the line?
Okay.
Like, does it work? Would you get...
Anyways, pickup lines don't work on me.
Let's see. I mean, depends upon the guy.
And depends upon how genuinely you say that. Okay.
Okay. So, you'll have to show the score there.
To there?
Yeah.
Okay, fine.
Okay. So have people hit on you anytime?
People don't hit on me.
Don't?
I laugh on their face.
Oh, that's such a turn off. Don't ever do that.
See, first of all, my friends were very scared of coming. I friend zone, first of all, okay? And if I friend zone somebody, I can't get back in love with
that
person.
That's the eternal art that girls are born with, right? Like, bro zone them, friend zone
guys?
Them. And that's it.
What a sexist you are. I have never mentioned that guys are like that. Why are you saying girls are like that?
It's not sexist. It's a very biological thing. Girls are born with it.
No.
It's an imprint mechanism.
Yeah, girls, please.
Yeah?
It's not that.
No, guys, support me on this.
Boy,
they're born with it, right? I mean, like, they friend zone you.
Boys. Exactly. And girls also get friend zoned, by the way. It's not that it's generally girls get.
I friend zoned a lot of people.
So what?
Okay. So here we go.
It depends on your genuinity, okay? Because I don't like pickup lines.
Okay. Fine. So genuine is. Okay, fine. Let me at least. Get into that zone.
Okay.
Not the friend zone or the bro zone, but the pickup line zone.
Okay.
Damn, girl. Is your name Wi-Fi?
Oh my God! When you said damn, I was...
Okay, girl, is your name Wi-Fi? Because I feel a connection.
Hey, what is the rating since 0 to?
0 to 5.
Minus 5? That bad?
Very bad. Damn, who says that? At least be good with the genuine thing, no? If the pickup lines are bad.
Okay. I'm working on something.
Are you...
Okay, this is not... Let me... Okay. My mom thinks I'm gay. Can you help me prove her wrong?
Oh, mamme. It's... you getting? I can't rate you also, I'm sorry.
Okay, it's fine. Bad. This is bad, I'll tell, but let me see if I can put it in the right way.
Fine.
Aside from being sexy, what else do you do for a living? Okay.
I can't say also.
Fine, okay.
So bad.
Fine. So let me just let's do an original thingy. So she hasn't even rated me a friend. Were you a broom in your previous life? Because you swept me off my feet. At least the second part of it is good, okay? Just
why I don't understand. Guys have that impression that they have to be very perfect in front of the girl and go and impress. I don't get impressed by that. If you'll be very perfect, no, you know, suit with the perfect hair, I'll not get impressed.
You even see me grooming and get ready for this?
I'm not talking about you.
Oh, okay.
I'm talking about other guys. All right, okay. So I don't like that concept of being very perfect, exactly correct talking and hitting. Okay. I might like a guy who's just, you know, shabby hair, in chappals, in torn jeans, sitting and talking and making, not making no sense, but then talking anything. But I like guys who are real, who'll actually genuinely, if they say something, I feel if they mean that. Okay, and I don't go by words. I go by the actions. I should feel that guy, I mean something to that guy. No?
Are you thirsty, Charlene, by any chance?
No, okay. Oh my God, this guy, I will never come to your show ever again. No. You are telling me that I'm a chatterbox.
No. Are you thirsty? Is it? You
because
said
talking too much?
Show your emotions. And I was like, okay, fine. Fine. Okay, let's just be done with this. Okay, I'm hoping I'll get it right somewhere or the other.
Oh my, do you have a girlfriend?
What?
do you have a girlfriend?
Okay, you're in the spotlight. Don't drag me into this.
No, because if your girlfriend is listening, she might be feeling very bad.
Okay. Chalo, last, let's give this. Okay. So, you've got something here. Okay. No, okay. No. There's something in your eyes.
Is there really something, or is making that up?
I think it's a sparkle.
Oh my God!
Come on, Shali, I know you liked it. Come on, you can't. See, you're blushing now.
This is how I blush?
I don't know, I'm blushing.
Oh my God.
They were all from the internet, so it's okay. Mine, they come naturally when I'm in the zone. You haven't seen me in the zone.
I don't want you to see. Okay. I don't want to see you.
Bad, huh? That bad?
Very bad.
Okay, fine.
Are you done with the pickup lines?
Yes. I don't think I'll venture into that any further.
You will not.
Yeah. Okay, so... What are the other pickup lines you've ever encountered?
I have encountered? Or
yeah, you have encountered.
Hey, I've never got a proposal also. People were, I used to get via, he likes you, but people were shy in front of me, I don't know why.
Okay.
I laugh also on their face. I laughed at one guy once. Because he didn't sound genuine.
That's the most terrible thing that you could do to a guy.
I didn't feel he's genuine.
Okay.
I'm telling you, I like people who are genuine. Who might just, I might get, I might really like somebody who will just come and say that, hey, you know what, I really like you, I think I really like you. And you know, when they say, it means, oh my God, you don't try it. It does not even suit you.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, I don't think so, you have a girlfriend, oh, and.
Yeah, I'm sure. Okay.
You have a wife?
No, at this stage in my life,
okay.
I don't have one right now, but yeah. Yeah. Okay. So yeah. So moving ahead. So how does the future look like from here onwards, Shalini? So you've got a couple of projects lined up?
As in, I've signed one. Okay. I am on talks with some.
100% Kadal.
Okay. I've signed that. And that shoot will start from 11th October, and I'm doing Mahanati. That is one, two projects that I've committed already, but I've not committed anything yet. So also, I don't know, I can't commit something where I can't get space for performance. I can't be just there and,
okay.
Because it's not that I'm saying that or degrading anybody, But it's like because I have been spoiled in a theater background, no? So I have that urge of performing. If I'm just standing there, I tell my director, hey, make me do something. I can't stand.
Okay.
I do that.
Okay.
So, or either if he'll not tell me, I'll do my thing and come.
So Mahanati is the biopic?
Of Savitri.
Of Savitri. And you are playing the character of Jamuna?
No.
Okay.
Was I supposed to reveal this? I don't know.
No, okay.
There were rumors, but I'm not playing Jamuna.
Okay.
But I will not tell you. Project. Yeah.
Okay. That's cool. That's cool. That's really nice. Mm-hmm. And so if you manage to get a role, I keep seeing a lot of these articles which say that heroines are stereotyped and cliched and stuff. Just one final takeaway. What is your opinion on that?
Because it's not the heroine's fault. First of all, they don't offer you roles like that.
Right.
There should be more scripts written like Queen.
Okay.
Okay. Like, I think it's happening in Hindi cinema. It's happening here also. I've seen good films. So there should be roles more portrayed. Even if there is a small appearance, okay, it does not matter. Okay. Screen presence does not matter. Even if it's one scene, it should be so strong that it should pull audience towards you.
Okay.
And I feel people should start writing because there are girls who will perform. They are not just meant for being the beauty in the film. They are meant to do a character in the film. And also, I feel that there's a impression in everybody that any heroine should look good.
Okay.
First of all, a character should look like a character and not good on screen. As in not beautiful with flat skin and with perfect hair. Even if you are doing a village scene, I don't get that impression.
Okay.
That if you're doing a village scene, how do you have perfect hair?
Right.
How do you have all gelled and, all perfect hair done, straight hair?
Yeah.
I don't get that. And I think people should work on that.
But I think at least now cinema is changing for the better.
I think, it's now. Yeah.
So before we depart or conclude this, I have a small article which I came across about you yesterday.
And I didn't read it. What?
Yeah. It is about Shalini Pandey.
Okay.
And here she says, I have temper issues that result in extreme mood swings.
Okay.
And it would be really nice if I could get rid of that.
Hmm.
In such scenarios, people close to me understand that I need space and just don't talk to me.
Hmm.
Coming up to the future, what do I see for this Diwali?
Hmm.
Is that I hope I always fancied a very tall, good-looking, smart guy.
Hey, and that's not written because I've read her. She sent me that. Okay.
You just said you didn't read it.
I didn't read exactly in that paper, but I know what's written there.
Okay, good.
Tall guy.
So you have temper issues. I'm really. It's tough for me to believe that someone like you has got anger management issues.
Anger management. You should ask my stylist. She's been living with me now. She's become. I'm living with her now. I have terrible mood swings.
Okay.
Not anger issue. It turns out to be an anger thing. And I'm not exact, but I have tacked this things of Arjun Reddy in me.
Okay.
How Arjun was. I am like that and I'm quite. If I am very moody, I want my own space. I don't want people to come and bug me. What happened? Hey, you'll be alright. Achha, tell me what happened. I don't like that.
Okay.
I don't like that at all. So just leave me. And I don't like pampering other people's ego. I can't do that.
Okay.
I can't do that. Genuinely, I can't do that. So, that also bugs me sometime.
Okay.
So, I have issues like that. It's not that I will go and insult you in front of the public. I'll not do that. I'm not evil or witch.
Mm-hmm.
But then, the problems is what I have issues, I face problems regarding that on my own self. I'll not create problems for others.
That's nice. Great. So, let's turn this over to the audience. Does anyone have any questions for Shalini Pandey?
Hey, why is everybody...
Do you have Walter Mitty?
Walter Mitty?
Yeah,
I have. I fantasize.
Okay.
I fantasize a lot and it's not from now on. I've been fantasizing and since college, how I went through the college was, if I don't like something, I'm not able to do it. So how I did it was, I used to imagine that I'm sitting in the classroom and I used to psych myself, Shalini, you're the heroine, there's one camera, it's a scene, just do it. So every day I used to do my college like that, you're the heroine of your class, it's okay. So I used to do that. So I fantasize life in a very large scale. So that's what
me.
I still do. Yeah.
So you always wanted to be an actor?
I always do. Touch pencil. Yeah.
Will you learn the language after coming over here, or because you're not traveling stuff, right?
Mm.
How do you manage?
Actually, when I heard the script, no, Sandeep told me that, can you dub for yourself? I said, I want to dub for myself because I am playing the character. I can't let anybody give the voice for me. I feel voice is your personal, I think voice is, reflects your soul, your character.
It's an extension of your person.
Can't, yeah. I thought he's making fun. I can't imagine anybody giving my voice. So I told that even if it's Telugu or any other language, I would learn it by heart, it understand it, but I'll dub for myself. So now I understand the language. Earlier I didn't know anything. I really rectified it. Every word, understood every meaning, because it's very difficult to do a scene, emotional scene in some other language without knowing what emotion. So I had to understand each and every word, giving pauses and stretches. So that I did. Hmm.
Guys, anything else? Hmm? Anyone? Your final chance, Shalini Pandey.
Oh my god, too much, huh?
Okay.
Yeah, okay. No questions? Okay.
So I think then we'll end it.
Hmm.
And we wish you all the best, Shalini.
Thanks.
Hey guys.
Hi, this is Venkatesh here.
This is Vijay Devarakonda.
Hi, this is Samantha.
Velamkonda Srinivas.
Watching Telugu Film Nagar.
Subscribe to Telugu Film Nagar.
Subscribe to Telugu Film Nagar.
Do subscribe to Telugu Film Nagar.
Telugu Film Nagar.
Please subscribe to Telugu Film Nagar.
You're watching Telugu Film Nagar.
Subscribe to Telugu Film Nagar for the latest updates.
Telugu Film Nagar. Chinna bell icon unta.